This episode, we're talking about slow motion and speed ramping. Let's get to it.
When you shoot in slow motion, after and post, you can use that as is. You can put it into normal motion, or you can do something that we are going to do right now, which is called speed ramping.
This is when you take a single clip, speed up one part, slow it down another, and then speed it up once more. I can use speed ramping to slow down a moment in time that is just too quick to catch at normal speed. Or alternatively, if I have a moment in my video that drags out too long, I can speed it up so I don't have to bore my viewers. The secret to good speed ramping is using contrasting variations of speed to highlight a moment in time.
Don't forget, you need to have a camera that shoots 60 frames per second.
If you want, you can even go higher to 120 frames per second, but don't ever go below 60.
So why should you want to shoot at a higher frame rate?
You need enough frames to begin with so that when you slow it down or remove those frames, you have enough of them left over to make your footage look smooth.
So if you shoot at a lower frame rate and slow your footage down, you may notice that it looks choppy.
So watch out and make sure you boost your frame rate.
You always want to balance your frames per second with your shutter speed. An unbalanced shutter speed may result in your footage having motion blur or ghosting. Your shutter speed should always double your frame rate. So with that in mind, let's take to this scene and let's shoot it up. Ready? Now. Awesome. So let's take exactly what I got and show you how we do this in post.
Hey guys, it's Heidi. So we're gonna take Jeff's footage and we're gonna edit it in post, and I'm gonna show you how to use the speed ramp feature. So I've already got Filmora opened. If you don't, open up Filmora. I already also have my footage imported into my media files. So I'm just gonna grab the piece of media that I want and drag that onto the timeline. My footage has already been filmed in slow motion. So I just wanna find the spot that I wanna ramp it up and speed it up. So I'm just gonna move the timeline marker to the place just to the spot where I see their faces disappearing. And then I'm gonna split the clip. And then I'm going to slide across the timeline here again until I see their faces reappear, just right there. And that's when I want the slow motion to start again. So I'll make another split. And so I'm just gonna double click on this clip that I've created and I'm going to speed it up. Let's try at 3 times the speed. So, I do that there. Yeah, that looks great. So I like the way that speed looks, but I also wanna try out other speeds to see if it looks better faster. Let's go to 5 times the speed. For me, that's maybe a little bit intense. So I'm gonna move that back down to 3. So when you're all done, you can hit export. Make sure in your settings that you've got your frame rate matching the frame rate of your video. Also, you need to double check that your resolution matches as well. And hit export. I say find target, it'll take me right to it. Hey guys, so that's speed ramping. Thanks for watching. I hope you enjoyed the video and I'll see you next time.
All right guys, I appreciate you. Thank you for watching. You've been everything and more. So subscribe and make sure you comment below.